Hi everybody, I'm Kirsten Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a nail that is about Bonfire Night or Guy Fawkes Night. If you are in a different part of the world, you may have no idea what this is, but all will be revealed. So, what year did this happen in?
Well, I don't know what year it happened in.
Many, many years ago.
On the 5th of November.
Yeah, on the 5th of November, somebody tried to blow up the Houses of Parliament. So now we celebrate this, weirdly so, and we call it Bonfire Night. So we have a fire, we have fireworks. The kids kind of enjoy it because there's fireworks and everything like that. And there's a film called
V for Vendetta
that's about Guy Fawkes Night. And in that film, there is a guy called
V.
And he wears this mask. Is he the guy that blows it up?
He's not Guy Fawkes, but he wears a Guy Fawkes mask.
He wears a Guy Fawkes mask, okay. So this mask is a Guy Fawkes mask, but it's probably those of you that are younger and in different parts of the world will know this mask as a anonymous mask. And that's what we're going to do. I think it's a pretty cool mask. I do think it's a cool mask. I like masks, clearly. I'm going to use mega white. Oh, it's mega. Mega it is. And obviously this is acrylic. And we're going to fill the entire nail to make the mask. And then this mask will fit on a little doll. So we're going to start with this white. We're going to build everything up with the white acrylic. What I'm going to do first of all is start to work with the forehead part. Now I aren't doing it too dry, it's quite a wet bead at the minute because I just want to map out where I'm going to put everything. And let's get some white onto this jawline. So you can see that I have filed the nail into a, I would definitely say this is a coffin shape, not a ballerina shape, because of the fact it has these straight sides. So it has straight sides here and it comes in very much a face shape. See, I'm mapping out where I'm putting everything. So we've got the nose there. The mouth will be there. I'll leave a little mark where I'm going to put the mouth. Then he has some serious cheeks going on. And he has quite small eyes because he's smiling, so his eyes go a little bit smaller. Right, okay, so now we've roughly mapped out where we are putting everything. I can start to build on this. I'm going to do these cheeks first. I wish I had cheeks like this. These are good cheeks.
You'd look very odd.
I probably would, to be fair. So you've got to make sure you keep it quite sharp here. So you've got a nice sort of crease where the cheeks are. Now I'm going to work on his nose. I'm always bleeding out my beads of acrylic. I need them to be not too wet. Now I need to do some nostrils, the outer part of the nostril. It's quite defined. So just use the very tip of the brush to open that out as well. So I've just done the top lip, and what I'm going to do is the bottom lip now. So I'm going to work on this bottom jaw and the lip at the same time. He's got like two creases that come from down the side of his mouth.
Massive dimples.
Yeah. I'm going to keep this gap though here. Right, so we've got this bottom lip here now. Notice how I'm concentrating on each part at a time. I'm not worrying about any other part. So now I'm just doing the lip and it's going to come round up here. And the lip, the height of the lip coming around here is going to help you to create the crease coming down here as well. So all you're going to do now is add here. Add some height. And then you've instantly got this crease here. You haven't got to cut into it as such. Going to do the same on this side. So this is what it looks like without his moustache. He kind of looks a bit strange without his moustache, I think.
It's like seeing the Joker with makeup on. You know, like normal face makeup.
Yeah.
Instead of white with the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't look the same, do they? I'm going to do his forehead now. get some height. What this will do is create his sockets for his eyes as well. Now he has two little sort of creases above his big massive black eyebrows. So we're going to create those. You are a strange looking fella. Right, what we're going to do now is, by the sides of his eyes, he has laughter lines. So with the tip of a brush, I am just going to cut in to make these laughter lines. He needs a bit of Botox. I need to create a bit of an eyelid here. Just a little bit of height. That will actually help build the eye socket as well. I'm going to do exactly the same on this side as I have that one. Oh, the paint palette's not been out for a while.
Wow.
That's what we're going to do now. We're going to do a bit of painting.
What makes you choose to use the palette?
Well, I just want to put a load of stuff on it. I just, you know, it's, mind you, I'm not going to use that many colours, so, but I am going to use the palette, because I feel a bit sorry for it. It's not had, it's, you know, it's not had the airtime it deserves. So we've got a bit of pale rose, a bit of red, of course we need black, and a bit of white. Some water, a clean bit of tissue paper. I'm going to start with these eyebrows. I'm going to follow the line that I've created already. He's got these like Ronald McDonald eyes, eyebrows going on. I think adding eyebrows instantly makes him look more, you know, like human, less alien-like. So I've got a brush with some acrylic liquid on, and I can use that to sort of just adjust anything.
You have to be really careful when you're just going straight onto acrylic with paint.
It sucks it up straight away. As soon as you work on acrylic with paint, it just sucks it up straight away. Like a sponge. So no mistake, he needs to be making surprisingly, acrylic liquid just scratches it off nicely. So I wouldn't worry too much. So eyebrows on fleek. Now we need, I'm going to do his goatee. His goatee beard. My brother has one of these little things. And mind you, it's quite long now. I mean, I think they're pretty pointless myself.
What, is that all he has?
Yeah, he just has a...
That a tash and that?
I haven't got a tash, I don't think.
Oh, God.
She's got this thing.
Yeah, they're just like, kind of clip her
head off. Yeah, all the time. The shape of this goatee beard is a bit like a tie.
A tie?
It's a bit like a tie. A tie shape. So you've got like your knot at the top. And then we come out again. Then we come down to a point. Now we're gonna do, we're gonna do his mustache. Right, so we go right up to the nose. And then we're going to come down in a V shape. V for?
Vendetta.
V for Vendetta. And it comes right down onto the top lip. Which I find very strange, but you know, I didn't make it. And then we're going to come along here. And we're going to go up to the cheek. Oh yeah, he's really looking like it now, isn't he? With his moustache. We need like a brown colour, like a dirty, dirty, dirty brown. Burnt sienna. I'm going to use that as well. With the two pink, oh no, I say two pinks, I've not got two pinks out, I've got a red and a pink. So I'm going to use the pink first, water it down, that's it. We're going to create the pink on his lip. He only actually has pink on his bottom lip. What's all that about? And then we're going to do the pink on his cheeks. Right, so we've got a bit of pink. Now I'm going to get the red, pick a little bit of red up and make a wash with the red, because we're just going to give a little bit more of a glow to the centre of the cheeks. Just needs a bit more of a glow, darling. It's just not glowing enough. We just needed a little bit more of a glow. And a slight bit on his lip. Oh, yes, darling. I'm loving this. I don't know why I'm talking like I'm awfully posh, because I really am not. I am going to black out his eyes. So I'm just darkening those nostrils. I'm basically just going to darken the areas that won't catch much light. And we're doing a wash because it's going to suck up the paint like a sponge. Mm-hmm. I am going to add. Sorry. Am I going to add? Like around. Just some little bits, do you know what I mean? Yee-hee! I don't know why I would laugh like that. I'm not going to cover it with top coat or anything like that. I'm going to put brush on glue over the top. I don't want it to be like really shiny, and I definitely don't want to lose any of the definition from the acrylic. So I'm going to brush over with some glue.
So how long would it last with brush on glue?
It would last. That's all I know. It won't wear away, you know, it'd last. If you were doing this on like a nail, like an accent nail, for somebody who is celebrating Guy Fawkes Night, this would last until the glue wore away, which I don't think that's gonna happen. The more glue you add, the more shiny it will get. We need to allow that to dry naturally. Don't get it wet. If you get it wet, it will turn like a funny white, like a white residue on it. You don't want to do that. So it'll leave a slight sheen to it. It'll have a slight shine to it, but it won't be as shiny if, you know, if you put the top coat on. Yes, it would be shinier, but you would take away the definition. Because as I rotate this, you can see all the definition still. Oh, I could just stick that on, Luke. Look at that. Hey! I quite like that. I might wear that myself.
Do for Bonfire Night.
Yeah, for Bonfire Night. So there you are, guys. That's how to create a mask celebrating Bonfire Night. If you don't celebrate Bonfire Night in your country, well, we all need an excuse to have a little celebration. So why not use the 5th of November for your little celebratory drink? Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Keep watching. Bye-bye.
Remember the 5th of November, the gunpowder, treason and plot. I know of no reason why the gunpowder treason should ever be forgotten.